my feel good breakfast show.
Very good morning, welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show on this Monday morning. Now, we all know that dressing for the red carpet has never been more important than it is today, and looking fierce has become a much sought after commodity. Now, on today's How To Fashion Guide, we're talking all things style cred. Your chance to get in on the glitz and glam to ensure you always are red carpet ready from dusk till dawn. And there's only one source, really, one source of inspiration you can go to when it comes to these things of importance. Of course, that is Mr. David Tlale. Ladies and gentlemen, David Tlale is in the house. Although I fear I might not have observed the correct protocol, so I must say Honorable Tlale.
Oh, please. Leave the honorable. Please.
It's so good to see you. How are you?
Good. Good to see you. How are you
Excellent.
Doing?
Very, very well. Fantastic. Thank you. Yeah. And you've been a busy man, like you were saying to me just during the ad break. It's getting busier now because we're going into the fashion shows coming up. But one massive fashion boom I think we've seen right now is this Afrocentric chic wear that's been associated with the Republic of Wakanda, if you
absolutely.
Will. And you also dressed some of our stars that attended the premiere at home, and you've dressed them abroad as well. Describe that experience. What was that like working with them?
It was really, really amazing.
Yeah.
First of all, we always say the red carpet, locally or internationally, is the number one trend-setting space because everybody wants to look like a particular superstar, a particular, I would say, icon.
Mm-hmm,
and because mm-hmm. young girls, boys, everybody aspires to be someone.
Yes.
So I think it's really exciting. And also to be headhunted all the way from London to dress Florence was really humbling for me because it just shows the journey over the past 15 years of building a brand to say there is a brand out in South Africa that I would say deem it worthy of dressing the red carpet stars. And it was really humbling to do that.
We are so, so proud of you for doing that. And then,
thank you.
For fast forward a couple of weeks later, we turning on our TV screens to hear the State of the Nation address. And here you are on the red carpet, speaking to all our leaders about their fashion and dressing some of them to understand it. How does that change when you go from celebrity to leadership?
I always say red carpet is red carpet. It don't matter who you are, what portfolio you're holding in life. People need to learn to respect the red carpet. When you say red carpet, it means gowns, it means fabulosity, it means the glitz and the glamour. It means consulting with your local designer. That's more important.
Yes.
More than anything, you can't just grab something from your wardrobe like the blast from the past because we've seen it somewhere on Instagram or anything. You have to always have something new on the red carpet.
Yeah.
And working with from superstars to like parliamentarians, there's a bit of mind shift mm-hmm. because you have to like be very sensitive to say, you know, when I'm done walking this red carpet, I need to be an MP.
Yes.
So you have to be conscious of such things. But you know what I really enjoyed, especially with this year's Sona, was like people are starting to appreciate local design.
They really are.
And it's really, really great to see our MPs and also celebrities starting to support local fashion designers.
Yeah.
And we want to see more of that coming forth because we know that Africa is the future and Africa is here. It's our time. It's our time to shine. I mean, you look at what has transpired with mm-hmm. the Black Panther, what has transpired at the Sona, and also, I mean, working with Mama Koni has been like really phenomenal because we have an amazing representation from South Africa, not only in fashion, but also in acting.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So can we just break it down a little bit from the celebrities to the parliamentarians and politicians to the normal everyday person who would like to introduce some glam into their day-to-day wear? What are some of your top tips? You know, simple things we can change up that could give us that thing.
I think the first thing is to understand who you are and understand your body shape and believe the mirror. I always say to people, believe the mirror. The mirror never lies.
Yeah.
When the mirror says you look wrong, believe it. Don't say, no, it's in trend, I gotta look good. Believe the mirror. The mirror says no, do not wear it. So if you wanna really build a beautiful wardrobe, start with basics. Above a beautiful white blouse, a pair of jeans or pants, or a little black dress, and especially for your cocktail.
Yeah.
And also now with this beautiful trend of African prints, always try to start collecting a few pieces like pants, blouses, jackets, and then you can always mix it up. And always, always, always Invest in beautiful shoes, good shoes, accessories, beautiful bags, because you can always lift your wardrobe with accessories. People think like, oh, you've got a new dress. Like, no, I've got a new pair of shoes. Yeah. You know, so it's very important to invest in basics that will last forever. Yeah. Don't buy cheap clothing from, I'm gonna say it like it is, stop buying cheap clothes from China, because you're gonna wash them today and they're gone. But if you buy fabrics from clothing from locally made, yeah, from local designers, it stays longer,
yeah,
and
yeah,
it's got longevity. And also, you know, the more you support the outside brands, you're killing the local market. Mm-hmm. You're taking someone's food on the plate. You are saying, you are not worth my money.
Yeah.
You are not worth living. So it's very important to support locally made products.
Yeah. And over and above that, our designers are worth it. The people that are producing, manufacturing, designing clothing, commodities, and products in South Africa are worth it.
Absolutely.
They are more than good enough.
So. Absolutely. I mean, yeah, for the fact that, you know, many years ago, House of Monati K in Cape Town used to manufacture for Yves Saint Laurent, it means we have it going. It means we've got the skill, we've got the craftsmanship. So can we start, continue supporting local clothing and textile industry? Yeah. It's very important.
Absolutely. Well, on a point of order, Honorable Tlale, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
I'm going to call you into order and not recognize the Honorable.
It's always such a pleasure having you here, sharing your time and your expertise with us. We really appreciate it. There you are. So, of course, always on point to impart some words of wisdom to aspiring creatives out there. Our big thanks to David Tlale. And, of course, if you'd like to be in on some of David Tlale's most stylish celebrity looks, head on over to our Facebook page and weigh in with your opinion. And that's your how-to fashion guide, only on your Feel Good Breakfast show.